ARL Commission Chairman Peter Volandis joins us. Peter, can you give us a bit of an update out of all these meetings? Where is the NRL competition up to?
Look, we're hopeful to play tomorrow. We've introduced some of the most stringent biosecurity protocols to allow us to play. We're going to provide them to the Queensland government and hopefully they'll allow us to play tomorrow. But all going to plan, you know, we should have three games tomorrow and possibly some on Monday. At worst, we'll play them on Tuesday, but we would prefer to play them tomorrow.
So your first preference would be all five games at Suncorp Stadium tomorrow. We're going to keep it localised to Brisbane?
Look, we'd like three games at Suncorp tomorrow and the other two at Suncorp on Monday. That's the plan at the moment. As I said, we've introduced some of the most stringent biosecurity measures. We've had all the players tested. They're already in level four biosecurity. They're going to be, you know, less people go to the grounds. But we're trying to do everything we possibly can that there's no risk to the Queensland government to allow us to play. But look, we're in their hands and we're respectful. We're in a pandemic. Their first priority is to look after the health of the community, and we appreciate that. But we believe this is a hiccup. Come Tuesday, if there's no more infections in Queensland, it'll be reopened and be back to normal as it was this time last week.
Yeah, Peter, really appreciate your time. I know how busy you've been. And as head of the commission and as head of racing, you've seen some pretty crazy days over the last couple of years. How does today rate?
Oh, look, I think there's been worse days than today. This one was just a bit unexpected, but we were ready for it, you know, and we had a plan in place to try to satisfy the government. But look, there was worse last year, I'd have to say. But I'm very confident this is just a hiccup and, you know, after Tuesday, we'll be back to normal.
Melbourne went into a three-day lockdown a couple of weeks ago. That lockdown ended up going for 2 weeks. Peter, you know, I know you're not a fortune teller, but what sort of contingencies and what sort of effect would it have if, in fact, Southeast Queensland stayed locked down for a couple of weeks?
Look, we've already had discussions with the Queensland government. If that did occur, and that's a worst case scenario, we'd be able to play with no crowds. That's one option. We have other options. You know, there's still Victoria, there's New South Wales, and we have been looking at these options. And, you know, we'll see what happens on Tuesday. We're quietly confident on Tuesday that the government will have it under control. It's one student who's given it to, you know, her family and some others in the class. So hopefully that's been contained. And if that's been contained, as I said, come Tuesday, we should be back to normal.
Peter, has it been discussed to relocate the players again to somewhere like North Queensland and play the games up there if you could have crowds?
Look, every option's on the table. And we had communication today from the Victorian government in wanting to assist us. So, look, we'll explore all those options. At the moment, we just want to play this round and hopefully we can do it tomorrow. If not, we just got to, you know, then prepare for next week. But as I said, I'm quietly confident because we've introduced some of the most stringent biosecurity protocols that, you know, that absolutely zero risk involved. But, you know, that's got to be signed off by the Chief Medical Officer in Queensland and the Queensland Government, and we're working very hard with them, and hopefully we'll know an answer sometime tonight.
I know the NRL is so diligent and working very closely with the Queensland Government. You mentioned that today's announcement was unexpected. So when Dr. Jeanette Young announced this morning that there would be no professional competition, did that catch you and the NRL a little bit off guard?
Yes, it did. Look, we were unaware. We were aware that the government did give us some notice that there may be a possible lockdown, but we just presumed that we'd be playing the games without the crowd. So we were a little bit surprised when the games were postponed because that wasn't what we expected. We expected to continue to play. Now, our players have been in a bubble. They've been, you know, with level four protocols, so they were very little risk. And we did it this way last year. We went to, you know, the matches with no crowds and we had never had a problem. And so it was a little bit of a surprise. But as I said, you know, we're in a pandemic. This Delta virus is certainly a lot more contagious than the Alpha virus. And I can understand some of the actions of the government.
Peter, it's Cooper. You just mentioned the players under stringent biosecurity protocols. What does this mean for the players' families actually in quarantine at the moment?
Well, it doesn't affect them because they're still in there until Wednesday. So if all goes to plan and, you know, the lockdown finishes on Tuesday, they'll reunite with their families on Wednesday and we're back to normal. Even if the lockdown continues, those families will go out of quarantine and with their husbands and partners. So they're not affected at this point.
What about the NRL players and the coaches? We spoke to Ivan Cleary, we spoke to Anthony Griffin. They're a little bit in the dark as well. There wasn't a lot of information trickling down. Are they now certain and comfortable with the direction that the schedule is headed and the expectations on them?
Look, we will give all that information once we have it ourselves. At the moment, we're still negotiating as to when we can play it. Hopefully, we'll have that sometime tonight, you know, early evening. And once we get that, we will relay that information to all our participants and especially the coaches and the players who have to play the games. But look, we're in the Queensland government's hands at the moment and we await their decision and then we'll relay that decision to everyone.
Peter, you've led the game through some dark times. Can the game's finances handle this uncertainty moving forward?
Look, we've been very fortunate. We cut our expenses by $50 million for this year and made it a much more cost-effective organisation. We've procured some new commercial revenues. So financially, we're okay. But today was very expensive for us because the tickets were selling very well for Suncorp. We had to fly the players to Rockhampton, which we had to abort. So we all had that expense. This all adds up, but fortunately, we were in a good financial position before this latest wave hit, and it shouldn't affect. It will affect us because it will be very expensive. But we should at worst break even for the year, which would be a good result.
An expensive day, an uncertain day, but you are a strong leader who is driven with solutions, not more problems. We really appreciate your time, Peter Volandis, and thank you so much for the wonderful partnership between Fox and the NRL and bringing us up to speed on such an uncertain day.
No, my pleasure, and we thank Fox for the partnership. It's a very successful and hope it continues for many more years.
Thanks, Peter.
Thanks, Peter.
Thank you.
Peter Volandis there, ARL Commission Chairman. You can imagine the kind of day and the conversations he has been having with multiple parties, not just the Queensland Government, but obviously everyone in the NRL, the 16 teams that are, they really weren't sure what today was going to be and uncertain what tomorrow would bring. But now it feels like their number one priority is to get back in business tomorrow and that Peter is pretty resilient, that he doesn't want to shut this competition down.
No, I guess that what he wants is to get this round out of the road. He stressed on that because if this round doesn't get done and drags into next week, then there's a problem for round 21, Vonnie. But he sounded pretty confident, as Peter Volandis always does.
It's true leadership. You've got to manage all the stakeholders, have conversations all day long and come to a desired outcome that suits all parties. So it's forever an evolving conversation. And Peter's done it before and he'll do it again.
So at the moment, it looks like no crowds, obviously, because of the lockdown.
Yep.
But he also mentioned Victoria and New South Wales. They were still an option.
Yeah.
As another relocation.
Could you imagine the players moving back into Sydney, but like we've got 8 LGAs that are in serious lockdown.
Yeah.
I don't know how that would work unless it was outside of Sydney.
Yep.
I can't imagine the players coming back into Sydney.
You just say that every option's on the table because whatever Tuesday produces, the NRL needs to be nimble enough to move and keep this competition running.
So now that Peter Volandis has had a bulk of those emergency meetings, that information has now been relayed to the clubs. Do you feel the players will feel more comfortable about the direction that this competition's headed?
Well, they will. But I don't know who's going to play tomorrow. And players will be sitting there waiting, thinking, wow, are we going to kick off at 12 o'clock tomorrow? If we're going to squeeze 3 games in, maybe we're on early. We don't know yet. Or maybe we're playing Monday.
A Super Sunday.
We could
a bad
do that.
Monday.
We could do that.
We only did a little Super Saturday today.
That's
I think
right.
We could do Super Sunday tomorrow.